Electricity is the lifeline of a civilization. Coal-based thermal power plants in India account for more than 65% of the installed capacity and 70% of electricity generation. Besides producing electricity, these thermal power plants also produce huge quantity of coal ash. During 2005-2006, coal ash generation was about 112 million tons, out of which about 45% was utilized gainfully in various works. India is amongst the leading nations in the field of construction industry. Bricks are the most common building material used in construction activities. Clay bricks have so far been used in construction works. Have you ever thought that by using soil in the manufacturing of bricks, we are not only eroding the upper layer of soil, but are also causing major damage to the environment? Concerned with the degradation of environment by manufacturing of clay bricks, Ministry of Environment and Forests issued a Gazette notification on 14th September 1999, making it compulsory to use at least 25% fly ash in clay ash brick manufacturing. Further, its amendment dated 27th August 2003 also makes it mandatory for all construction works within 100 kilometers of a thermal power station to use ash bricks and other ash-based products in all construction works. Fly ash generated in coal-based thermal power stations is a very versatile material and can be gainfully utilized in making of clay fly ash bricks, fly ash lime bricks, or fly ash cement bricks. This film covers the various aspects involved in making of fly ash lime bricks and fly ash cement bricks. Fly ash is a pozzolanic material. This means that fly ash on its own is not cementitious but acquires cementitious properties once it gets in touch with lime and water. The process of fly ash brick making uses this property of fly ash to acquire additional strength. Raw materials required for making fly ash bricks are fly ash, sand or stone dust, and lime plus gypsum or ordinary Portland cement, OPC. The manufacturing process of ash bricks requires proportionate mixture of fly ash, sand or stone dust, lime and gypsum. Lime and gypsum are first ground in pan mixer with optimum water. Ash and sand or stone dust are then added to form a uniform mixture. When cement is used in place of lime and gypsum, fly ash and sand or stone dust is first mixed in pan mixture and then cement is added to have a uniform dry mixture. Water is added into the pan mixer once the uniform dry mixture of fly ash, sand or stone dust and cement is achieved. The mixture is then transferred to a molding machine. In the molding machine, the mixture is either hydraulically pressed or compacted through vibratory press. Once the bricks are taken out of the mold, they are air dried for about 1 or 2 days. Water curing is then done for about 14 days to achieve required strength. The quality of bricks produced by this process depends on the following factors: quality of raw material, proportioning of raw materials, handling and mixing of raw materials, handling and pressing of the mix, and curing. Fly ash for use in making bricks should preferably be from first or second fields of electrostatic precipitator. However, pond ash can also be gainfully utilized for making ash bricks. While selecting sand or stone dust, care has to be taken to ensure that deleterious materials such as clay and silt in sand or stone dust are not more than 5%. Hydrated lime of C grade is to be used. This should be free from extraneous materials and lumps to the extent possible. However, sludge lime of consistently good quality can also be used. Gypsum to be used should be free of lumps. Purity of gypsum should be above 80%. Alternately, ordinary Portland cement OPC can also be used in place of lime and gypsum as binding material. Proportioning of raw materials is an important aspect of ensuring quality of ash bricks. The proportioning will depend on the quality of the raw materials and the class of brick required. Generally, following mix proportion gives compressive strength of 75 to 100 kg per square centimeter. Fly ash 60 to 65%, sand or stone dust 18 to 27%, hydrated lime 8 to 12% and gypsum 5%. Second, fly ash 55 to 60%, sand or stone dust 20 to 25%, sludge lime 15 to 20% and gypsum 5%. Third, fly ash 50 to 60%, sand or stone dust 32 to 40% and ordinary Portland cement OPC 8 to 10%. The proportion of mixture may be finalized by a few trial mixes to produce good quality bricks of required compressive strength and water absorption. Cost of a set of 4 vibro presses along with pan mixer is about Rs. 6 lakh. About 8,000 bricks can be made per shift with these machines, engaging about 15 to 16 labourers. Cost of hydraulic press is about Rs. 15 lakh. About 8 to 10,000 bricks per shift can be made with this machine, engaging about 8 to 10 labourers. In both cases, about 1 acre land is required for storage of raw materials and fly ash bricks. Bureau of Indian Standards has issued detailed specifications for ash lime bricks as per IS 12894-2002. NTPC is using fly ash bricks in all its construction activities. In NTPC Sipat, a greenfield project, fly ash bricks are being manufactured at NTPC Korba, located at a distance of about 80 kilometers. Fly ash bricks are being regularly used in all NTPC expansion projects. In Pune, Magarpatta Township is being developed by making and using fly ash bricks. The township is spread in an area of about 180 hectares consisting of residential units, technology parks, commercial offices, hospitals, schools and colleges, hotels and restaurants, and shopping malls. Number of brick-making machineries have been installed in the Magarpatta Township area, which are producing about 80 to 90,000 bricks per day. After the devastating earthquake in Bhuj, Gujarat in January 2001, reconstruction work has started with fly ash bricks. Fully mechanized fly ash bricks with autoclave curing has also started in Delhi. RRL Bhuvaneshwar has developed a technology on manufacturing of cold setting fly ash bricks by using more than 90% fly ash in presence of chemical activator.
RRL Bhubaneswar has developed a new process in manufacture of cold setting fly ash brick and other building material products using fly ash 90 to 95% in presence of chemical activator 2 to 5%.
NTPC Talcher Kaniha has taken up the work to demonstrate the process of cold setting fly ash bricks through RRL Bhubaneswar. Infrastructure development in India is increasing at a rapid rate. Ash bricks have a big role to play in the development of our country. With the existing technology and the technology being developed, more and more ash is poised to be gainfully utilized in the construction activities.